simplify the square root of 10,584? Why would I ever want to do that? Oh well, it's the problem, so we'll knock it off. We know how to simplify square roots. We pull out perfect square factors, so let's go hunting for some perfect square factors. Well, last two digits of this are 84. That's divisible by 4, so we know that 10,584 is divisible by 4. That's our nice little divisibility rule for 4. So now we divide 4 into this to see what's left. 4 goes into 10 2 times, carry the 2. 4 goes into 25 6 times, carry the 1. 4 goes into 18 4 times, carry the 2. 4 goes into 24 6 times. So we've got 2646 left. Now we can't pull out another factor of 4. 46 is divisible by 2, but it's not divisible by 4. So 46 is not divisible by 4. But it is divisible by 9. The sum of the digits is 2 plus 6 plus 4 plus 6 is 18. 18 is divisible by 9, so 2646 is divisible by 9. We can pull that perfect square factor out. Divide 9 into this. We'll get 9 into 26 goes twice, leaves 8. 9 goes into 84. 9 times leaves 3. 9 goes into 36 4 times. 9 times 294 is 2646. Now, don't see any more perfect square factors I can pull out of 294 right away, but just to be sure, I'm going to go ahead and break that down as much as I can. I'll pull out a 2. It's obviously even. 2 goes into 294 147 times. 147 is a multiple of 3 because the sum of the digits is 12, which is a multiple of 3. So I pull out a factor of 3. 3 goes into 147. 49 times. Found another perfect square factor. So I've got 3 perfect square factors here that I can pull out of this. So I can write that square root as the square root of 4 times 9 times 2 times 3 times 49. Now we can break this up. Square root of 4 times the square root of 9. I'm just going to leave the 2 and the 3 there, nothing to pair them with. 2 times 3, and I've got my square root of 49 here. Square root of 4 is 2. Square root of 9 is 3. Square root of 49 is 7. And 2 times 3 is 6. 2 times 3 is 6. Times the 7 is 42. And the square root of 10,584 can be simplified as 42 times the square root of 6, which is a whole lot simpler than that. Not sure why we want to know that, but on to the next. Oh my goodness. Well, there's our square root of 10,584 again, so at least we'll make some use out of that last problem, but I certainly don't want to just write out 4 copies of this and start multiplying them all together, and that'll take all day. So let's try simplifying these square roots, and maybe something good will happen. We've already taken care of the first one. We know that the square root of 10,584 is just 42 times the square root of 6. So let's check out 2 times the square root of 24. Well, we see an easy perfect square factor we can pull out there. 24 is just 4 times 6. So this is 2 times the square root of 4 times the square root of 6. Square root of 4 is 2. 2 times 2 is 4. And we get 4 times the square root of 6. And we're on to 11 times the square root of 54. And here we see 9 is an easy perfect square factor to pull out. We have 11 times the square root of 9. Times the square root of 6. Square root of 9 is 3. 3 times 11 is 33. We have 33 times the square root of 6. And now we see how simplifying square roots can be so useful. When we substitute these simplifications back into this giant mess up here, we get a slightly less scary mess. And what's slightly less scary about this is that we see we have the same square root in each of these terms, square root of 6, square root of 6, square root of 6. So we can combine these just as if this were 42x minus 4x minus 33x. We could combine all those. We can combine all these into, let's see, 42 minus 4 is 38. 38 minus 33 is 5 times the square root of 6. And we're raising that to the fourth power. This is a lot simpler than that. Now we can raise this to the fourth power. We use one of our exponent rules. We have a product raised to the fourth power. We can write that as the product of fourth powers. Now, the fourth power of a square root, not so sure how to deal with that, but we can use one of our exponent rules to break that down a little bit. We can write this as the square root of 6 to the 2 times 2 power, and now we can break that up into the square of the square of the square root of 6. Yeah, that's what I said. Try to say that 5 times fast. It's pretty hard. Let's write that down, and you'll see the exponent rule at work here. We have 5 to the 4th still, and then we have the square of the square of the square root of 6. And there's our exponent rule. We have the square root of 6 squared, and then that squared again, we can write that as square root of 6 raised to the 2 times 2, which is the 4, and we're just going the other direction because we can deal with the square of the square of the square root of 6. I love saying that. Practiced it all morning. We can deal with the square root of the square root of the square root of 6 a lot easier than we can deal with the fourth power of the square root of 6, because the square of the square root of 6 is just 6. So this is 5 to the 4th times 6 squared. Now to pound this out, I'm going to write 5 to the 4th. I use another one of our exponent rules. And I'm going to write this as 5 squared times 5 squared. That's just 5 to the 4th, because you have 4 5s total. And now I have a product of squares. And I can write that as the square of a product. Product 5 times 5 times 6. And that's a product that's easy to evaluate. 5 times 6 is 30. 30 times 5 is 150, and we have 150 squared. 15 squared is 225, so 150 squared is 22,500, which is way simpler than this giant mess up here. All right, on to our last challenging square root problem. This doesn't look anything like the other square root problems we've done. I mean, there's a variable in there, and how do we know that this is an integer? Well, we know 315 will work. If we put in 315 for n, we'll have 315 times 315, and the square root of 315 squared, that's just 315, but it might be smaller numbers that work, and we could test them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 until we hit one. That doesn't sound like fun, does it? No. But we can simplify the problem. We can simplify the problem by simplifying the square root. We know we can simplify this because the sum of the digits here, 3 plus 1 plus 5 is 9, tells us 315 is divisible by 9. We can pull out a perfect square factor. We have the square root of 315n, square root of 9. Take out a 9, we're left with 35. 9 times 35n. And we can write that as the square root of 9 times the square root of 35n. So that's just 3 times the square root of 35n. And I don't see any more square factors that I can pull out, but just to make sure, I'll write down the prime factorization of 35. That's just 5 times 7 times n. Now, I need this square root here to be an integer in order to make this whole thing an integer, because I know n is an integer. So in order to get more perfect square factors that I can pull out, well, I need a factor of 5 in n to go with this 5, so I can pull that out. And I also need a factor of 7 in n in order to be able to pull out get rid of these 7s and pull that out. So, now I see that this is definitely an integer, because this is 35 and that's 35, so this is just 3 times the square root of 35 squared, which of course square root of 35 squared is just 35. So I see in order to make this an integer, I need n to have a factor of 5 and have a factor of 7. And I see that that's enough. Once I do that, this pops out as an integer. So the smallest possible n that makes this an integer, the smallest possible positive n, is 35. And we're done.